Welcome to the Bubba Army YouTube channel.
Man, it's like riding a bike, having Hatley in here. Hatley, you should come in, you know, with our kind of loose-knit schedule, willy-nilly. You know, you should just every once in a while when you get a little bug about coming in and wanting to get some stuff off your chest, you should just come in. We got a great delivery mechanism.
I would love that. I'd absolutely love it.
And the biggest, and by the way, Brent Hatley, ladies and gentlemen, his lovely wife, who I've always been a huge fan of, Caitlin. Her real name's Caitlin, but I like to call her Caitlin. Hello, Caitlin.
Hi.
Get closer to that mic.
You get closer to that mic. You know how to work that mic.
Like, you know, like it's a deal.
Hey, Brent, how many times in our careers do we have to tell the people to eat the mic like it's a penis?
Every single guest we have to tell that.
Like, Caitlin, literally think you're at Caliente and there's a penis right there.
Okay, I got it now.
Yeah, sure.
I got it.
No further instructions needed. But, you know, Brent, the one thing I want people to know is that you were with me for, I think, 13 years.
Correct.
And, like, there's been, like, people Hatley left under bad conditions. And, you know, Brent and I don't think have ever been at each other's throats. When he left, it was mutual. I cried. I didn't want him to leave, but it was time for him to leave. I was in all kinds of problems and messes. Brent had to spend half the time as my personal attorney and half the time as an executive producer.
Yeah.
And it was probably just time for you to go see the world and do the world, which you did, and realize, and it has nothing to do with my show. It has more to do with geographically where you live. That, wow, Tampa's pretty kick-ass. I need to get back there.
Yeah, 100% true. And it was after that, you know, 5 years of being sued by Todd Schnitt.
Oh, I know.
It burned me out because, you know, we had to do the morning show, and then I had to go over with the kick-ass Diacos and do depositions a lot of afternoons.
And then sometimes come back 20, 30 minutes before the afternoon drive show after you've been working. We've been over there hitting the weight pile, and you've been over there doing legal beagle, you know, Pelican Brief.
Oh, yeah. Listen, sitting there deposing MJ.
Yeah, exactly. So anyway, Brent left tonight. Was it 13, bud?
Yeah, 2013.
Well, what a lot of people don't know, and I think we've told this story before, is that Brent first, I was at 98 Rock, and Brent originally worked at 98 Rock as a promo guy.
Yeah, I was the assistant promotion director after being an intern there.
Which means he just held banners and, you know, for Seabass.
True. I used to have to go hang banners for that idiot.
I know you did. So then I roll up into the building and Hatley figures it out quickly. This guy looks like he's kind of, you know, maybe kind of running the show around here.
Yep.
And whatever he wants, they seem to give him.
Yeah, two of us figured that out, and we got to stay.
So
myself and Big Rig got to keep our jobs. Everybody that went against Bubba got fired.
So Brent comes to me, and he automatically starts putting on the Hatley charm. Like, he automatically figure out who my favorite football team is. Like, you know, the first time I meet the guy, he starts like, you know, hey, the Packers going to be good this year. And I'm like, I like this guy. I really like this guy.
Knows how to work.
Because Hatley knows how to work. Don't let anybody fool you.
Mm-hmm.
Hatley knows how to work. So I then go to the management and I'm like, listen, I want this guy to be my producer. He's working for Ron Diaz and he's scheduling,
Let's back up one step. I was the promotions director of Thunder 105.5 or 103.5. And
right.
You went to management and said, hey, you're putting Ron Diaz on. Put this guy on his show, and when he learns how to be a producer, then I want him.
Yes.
That's what you told Brent
Harden. You got this guy scheduling, you know, who's going to be at the Beer Fest.
Yeah. making sure the Gator's blowing up.
Making sure. Get this guy that's selling weed and fake tickets in Gainesville on the weekends. Get him down here. Get him up here doing something.
Wasn't that Thunder's big deal was the Gator?
No, that was 98 Rock. Thunder, we had Thor.
Oh,
so
Thor, okay.
I had to carry Thor.
Make sure Thor didn't have a hole in it.
Yeah. Set that up out at the... Beach nuts.
They had you straight jobbed.
Yeah.
So I'm like, hey, let this guy, you know, learn how to be a little producer with Ron Diaz. Ron's going to play 6-7 records an hour. He'll, you know, and then I'm going to steal him away because I hate my guy. And because my guy's a lazy piece of shit with a Z. So Brent did that till 2000. And then I hired Brent to be my producer, executive producer on air. And he was with me for 13 years.
Yep.
Then you went to LA and you thought you've always been an L.A. guy, like, oh, L.A., 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 but L.A. sucks.
L.A. really sucks now. But when we were there, you know, we lived in Pasadena for a year, and I worked with Neil Strauss, who's a fantastic author. You know Neil.
Oh, The Game.
Yes, the guy that wrote The Game.
Yep,
he also wrote The Dirt, the about Motley Crue. Mm-hmm. He's great author. And then I also worked with Mary Lou Henner and at KFI, which is the clear.
Kaylin, what were you doing in LA? I think OnlyFans was around then.
No, I was in commercial real estate, and I
closer
worked,
to the mic.
I was in commercial real estate, and I worked at basically like in
that
property.
That sucked, didn't it?
She leased medical buildings.
Yeah, so I could walk to work.
Yeah, okay, great, walking to work. But man, I mean, you know, and what, Brent? Wasn't rent sky high out there?
So rent in L.A. We had a 1-bedroom apartment in L.A. that was $2,100 a month.
Right.
So,
so you were there about what, a year and a half, years?
One year almost on the dot. So,
right.
So we had been there about 8 months, and I got a call from Jeremy Coleman, who is the senior vice president of the Howard Stern channels. And he said, I'm going to be in town. Can you come down and meet me at the Sirius XM for an interview?
So The LA Sirius XM.
Right. I'm like, hell yeah. Also, I got an interview with the TV NFL Network, which is in Venice, California.
Right.
It was both the same week, actually. So the NFL Network offered me a job, but said, listen, the NFL Network digs into your they talk to your dog about you. Their background check is so long.
So they found out you scalped tickets and had a bag full of weed in Gainesville?
I passed the NFL background check, but it took 3 weeks. So the day the NFL background check comes back, I also had a job offer, an official job offer from Howard.
Now, did you know Howard called me?
Yes.
Howard called me.
Yes.
Bubba Howard. Hey, what's up? We were thinking about hiring Brent. But I wanted to, he was completely old school about it. And you know, Howard doesn't pick up the phone very often.
Almost never.
He likes to email, but he actually called me on this and said, like, we're thinking about, you know, maybe hiring Brent, but I wanted to get your blessing. And I go, Howard, not only do you have my blessing, but it would be super cool, like, for my guy to go, like, please. And so I don't know if you knew that or not.
I did know that. Marcy told me that.
Yeah. So then you're New York, and outside, I mean, working for Howard's unbelievable. You're never going to hear me say a bad word about Howard, but New York sucks. Does it not? And you were there, you and Kaylin were there right when this pandemic thing hit. And I think that's one of the reasons why you got back home.
Yeah, that's definitely one of the reasons that we came back. There was some changes that were made at SiriusXM that they had a big staff meeting with us, and they said, we're going to make these changes. And then the pandemic was coming. So I watched the BBC a lot because the BBC world news has no opinion in it. It's actual news.
And those Brits are stiff,
are they
not?
Yeah, they're stiff.
Do they hate us? Yeah. They think we're a bunch of white trash.
You can't tell what their opinion is,
right?
Because they're so
that's good,
stoic about everything. So I have no idea what their opinion was, but they were covering this pandemic in Europe. I was like, well, common sense would tell you that New York City is going to be the worst place first. So we're not staying in any place where people are on top of each other and there's a pandemic. So we packed up our stuff. We threw away about 3/4 of our apartment. We rented a minivan and we
looked like the Griswolds going back to Florida.
And hauled ass to Coco's house.
Really?
Yes. Yes. That's exactly. I mean, we got out of there as fast as we could.
We slept at gas stations.
Yeah, we knew because the building that we lived in Jersey City, which is like the 6th borough of New York, and our building shut down. They shut down the gym. They shut down, like, they had a rooftop where we'd go up there and smoke weed.
Hold on, Brent. We can't talk about this here, but you know the chat. You know how chat is.
Dealt
with them.
Oh, God.
Somebody goes, Kaylin loves the BBC.
And she does. She likes the PWC.
Okay,
BLC.
We'll get into all that there. But we're talking about the British Broadcasting Communications Network right now. But
yeah.
Kaylin's BBC probably is a tick different than that. Hatley, is this the thinnest you've ever been?
This is the thinnest I've been, since...
I mean, since you were at Rob Kahn's?
No, this is the thinnest I've been since I was a Marine.
For real?
Yeah, I was even weighed a little bit more of this when I was at Rob Kahn's.
Now, are you training? Are you just eating differently? Like what?
I'm lifting weights. I'm having lots of sex and not eating nearly as much as I used to. I used to smash the food, and these days, not so much.
Now, do you remember when I got married, buddy? We were trying to actually get you to like 260.
Yeah.
You remember that? We had a contest and we were trying to get you to like, I think the highest you made it was like 251
or something like that. Yeah, because you guys would like order in like Sonic for me, and it would be like 3 or 4 burgers
it was a thing we were trying to like, and you were like, yeah, let's get as fat as I can.
And then I'll show you how I can lose it.
You want to get fat so you could lose it.
Yeah, and I got really fat. If you look at a picture, there's a picture I have one picture of me with Howard, one. and it's at his birthday party in 06. Bubba and I were both there.
Oh, I was looking good as hell.
You were looking great, and I'm standing next to Howard, and I look like a huge blob.
Is that where we had to kayfabe?
Yes. Yeah, that was the biggest kayfabe of all, and we pulled it off.
I know, and you know what, Britt? I mean, even Blitz, I don't know, other than Doug Goodstein, if anybody, I don't even
Doug
know.
Doug Goodstein and Scott DePace.
Are the only two that know the kayfabe?
Oh, and one more guy, Baba Booey. Those three.
And Baba Booey.
Yep, those three.
I remember Baba Booey coming to me and goes, Baba, what kind of deal do you got going on around here? What the are you doing? I'm like, Baba Booey, just make sure all that footage is gone.
You know what? You got to give those guys credit for being men's men.
Yes, they were. They covered it. And I think Robin and Howard knew a little bit about it.
Yeah. And you know, they're old school, too, like that.
But, right.
But those guys were men.
But I was in a little bit of a conundrum, and I had to go to Hatley. And I go, Hatley, you got to get a hold of Goodstein and stuff, and there's some stuff that's got to disappear around here.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that was like our first week there.
Yeah.
They should have known we were going to be problems, Hallie. We're already asking K5 stuff.
And then all that Baba Booey said was that next week he came in and goes, Baba and Brent are a lot of trouble. It's good trouble, but they're a lot of trouble.
Donkey Teeth gifted 14 subs and Thuggish Ruggish Nerd 1,000 bits.
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
Thuggish Ruggish Nerd's awesome.
So,
love that guy.
So listen, I'm going to wrap it up here. I got so many questions for you. And if it's okay with you and Caitlin, I wanted to do kind of the state of the Hatley.
Sure.
And the one thing about you and Caitlin is that you are so transparent and very honest about what you're doing.
Absolutely.
And what you're into, and her OnlyFans and a couple other ways that she monetizes her content. And I think that my fans would, a lot of them don't really know what Caitlin's doing or you're doing.
I had two people message me like, man, you need to make sure you ask questions about what they're really doing. I said, they talk about it everywhere. Like, what are you talking about?
LM Close, 10,000 bits for the Hatleys. Ooh, how about that?
Thanks.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah, listen,
thanks.
Caitlin's going to say, you know, I like, you know.
They don't hide it.
There's nothing. Yeah.
Go to CaitlinHatley.com and you can see it all right there.
How about her OnlyFans?
Yeah, well, that site's links to all of her
of
OnlyFans, Cameo.
I wish you were
stuff.
This IT savvy when you work for me, you son of a bitch. Anyway, Brent, we're going to have you guys back in about 15 minutes.
Awesome.
It's the state of the Hatleys. No holds bar. Caitlin, your new set of Diacos are quite scrumptious.
Thank you.
Girl, 1,000 bits.
Blitz, I mean, I'm sorry. Brent, can we verify that those are like less than a year old Diacos, are they not?
They're a little bit more than that, but they are Diacos.
Authentic.
Yeah.
They are authentic Diacos.
Authentic.